couple of my chickens got sick. They got disease, and it was an incurable disease. I had to kill them. And saw some method where, like, I hung a cone, like an orange cone upside down, his head's out, and he just slit the throat. Just sprayed all over me. I was like, cool, that was my bro, and I just slit his throat, and I just shot blood all over me. He had a disease, so his body was immobile. He couldn't control his body functions. Figured, you know, you hear you cut the chicken with the head off, they fly. Figured he can't move, he's not going to fly. As soon as I chopped the head off, things flying overhead high, spraying blood all over me again. And I'm just like, are you kidding me? This blood is everywhere. This is my, like, my little homies fucking without a head flying. It sucked. And I was like, all right, I'm trying this shit out. I'm trying the vegan thing out. You're like, let's do what you would normally do on today. And actually, today's Tuesday. Daisy always works on Tuesdays, so Tuesdays are always my, pretty much always my don't leave the house and take care of shit, because she's gonna work and I got the kiddo.
This is bad. I'm starting to really think I'm like redneckly. I don't want to be this way.
This is what we're doing. We could be doing anything. And this is what I got you doing.
But you asked for it.
This is mine. This is mine. And skateboarding, I don't know. I like having a different take. I like kind of doing it my way. Like, everyone does it their way. Everyone's an individual. Living out here definitely is a step out of the norm as far as professional skateboarders go, I guess, because I'm very professional. Very, very professional. I lived in LA for like 3 years. We had Lila. I was starting to look into schools to figure out, like, okay, well, what kind of school, what school is she going to go to, this, that, and I didn't see myself raising a kid in the city. I always dreamed of this as a kid, so I figured, you know, I'll give my kid that, and hopefully that's what she's into, because that's what I always wanted to have animals and stuff as a kid like that. I'll go years without seeing friends in the industry that, like, I would love to see all the time, but I'm over here, dude. Like, when I go skate LA, I just go there, skate, and then come home. Can't travel city to city to city and then go back to a city. I have to be able to fucking do that, spread my arms. And I made a fucking skate park, dude.
They're fine if they're up there.
I always hated, I always thought being a skate park kid would be so lame, but I'm a fucking skate park kid. I don't know, I when I was a kid I had tumors in my foot. They took it out, but they must have left a piece. It was benign, it wasn't cancerous. And then it grew back like instant and big. They ended up removing, like, they took out all the meat touching it. So basically they pretty much removed my whole arch. Like, when I was a kid, dude, I was out for like 6 months at a time, like back to back. It was like torture. You know, of course, like, doctor was like, yeah, your age with a surgery like this, with how much we're taking out, like, you're gonna walk with a limp. Your life is not gonna be what it was, you know? I'm like, great. And I was like, well, can I skateboard? He's like, you should not be worrying about skateboarding. Like, just pretty much like, that's probably not gonna happen. I was watching an old 4-on-1, and John Comer had a little piece in it. He was skating with a fake leg. I'm like, what? This fucker's doing that? Like,
when I was a little kid, I got hit by a car behind my house. And I was 4, and then when I was 8, they had to cut my leg off.
I was in crutches, and I was like, can I try your skateboard? And I was just like, I just was riding my crutches down the street because I saw John Comer skate with one leg, and I was like, fuck that, I'm gonna skate. I would go in for yearly checkups. The doctor was always like, wow, you are skateboarding. Like, that's awesome, man. He's like, I just didn't really think that would happen again for me. I know. There's not that much out here. So you have to, you know, open your eyes and really hunt and search. And it kind of makes them more, for a more creative street skater. And I think it's kind of cool. I'd be bummed if they switched it out and made like really good skate parks, because it would change the way kids skate here. You wouldn't see the next generation skating like these guys. It'd be like just really good and boring and with no eye. These guys have eyes and it's cool.
Your shoulder talk. Thank you.
That was all my tap her out talk.
Yeah, tap her out.
That was amazing.
There's a checkoff list in order to get on the team. You had to get like seven photos in the mag and like whatever. I showed some of my footage there and they're like, any handrail trick, he'd rewind it and frame by frame till I got on the handrail and then like sigh, like, press play, and I was just like, oh my god, if this is it, this is what being a sponsored skateboarder is, fuck this. At that point, I decided, I was like, fuck this, I'm buying skateboards for the rest of my life, I don't ever want to be sponsored again, I was over all of it. And then the way I got on Crooked was, I was just going to be flow, you know, like, just flow for Crooked. And I was perfectly content with that, because those were the boards I was buying. Van calls me, he's like, hey, can you come out to New York tomorrow? I'm like, what? Like, I'm in fucking Salt Lake City or wherever the hell I was. Yeah, but you should come out. You need to come out tomorrow and come on a Crooked trip. And he just muscled me into the video. They did not plan on me being in the video at all. He forced me into the scene, basically. Like, I was his dude. I didn't go through, like, the flow for a year or two. It was just like, Van's just like, nope, you're coming here, and then you guys are filming. I got a bad taste in my mouth for the skateboard industry, and then I was wrong. So this is the skateboard industry? Like, are you kidding me? It's like this? I would have tried to have done this earlier. This is cool, you know? To my first DIY. I feel like every pro skateboarder that makes it to 30, I think it's like we all go through like a midlife skateboarding crisis where you're like, I'm not a young kid that's competing with these other young kids, and you're not a legend, you know, like, you're in this weird little middle ground. And I think a lot of pro skateboarders around my age kind of start panicking, and I have fully. To me, like, I feel skateboarding owes no one anything. It never has, never will, and I hold on to that, because if I felt that skateboarding owes me a couple more years of being sponsored, I'd be fucking the worst. I don't like those people. I'm gonna keep skateboarding as much as I do until I can't provide for my family, and then happily move on to the next stage of my life. I'm not gonna hold on to the dream any longer than it needs to be there. I've already gone way further than I ever thought I could.